screen.
Okay, hey everybody. My name's Jordan. I'm an engineer at Defang. My teammates and I have been cloud engineers for
over a decade now.
And despite being
experts in the field, we think it's still too hard to ship your app to the cloud, especially if you're just getting started, trying to get your business off the ground, trying to fiddle around with deployment is probably the last thing that you want to be worried about.
So
we looked around and tried to think about, how can we, what's the easiest way to get this done? So you can go to the Amazon dashboard, you can go into the various services, you can create the different resources that you need. Over time, it gets really hard to kind of even keep track of what have I created, where is it, how are the things associated to each other. So the other, other tools have come around in the last few years. There's a tool like Terraform, there's CloudFormation, there's Pulley, there's a bunch of different options. All of these tools require you to learn a whole new set of things. So now you need to kind of know the cloud that you're targeting, and you also need to know this tool. So we were a little bit frustrated by this, and we thought, locally, we're using Docker Compose to describe the shape of our application for our local development environments. Wouldn't it be great if we could take that sort of description of our applications and ship it to the cloud?
So that's what Defang does. We
take your Docker Compose file, which we think is a really great sort of description of the essence of your application, the different services, and how they relate to each other. And we translate that into the sort of cloud-specific infrastructure as code resources that you would need to make to ship. So I'll give you a demo of how that works. Today I'm going to demo a really simple app. It just is a quick little text box. You can ask a language model what's up. So the app looks like this. This is my compose file. There's a couple services here. There's an app. This is a show it to you real fast. This is a Flask server. Pretty straightforward. There's an ask endpoint and a root endpoint with an HTML page. This actually uses something, I'm not gonna spend a bunch of time on this, but Docker recently shipped a really cool model runner locally. So you can actually leverage this provider type model configuration in your compose file to get a locally running language model. And then you have a nice local development environment. And then when you ship this compose file to the cloud, Defang will actually replace that with a service that hot swaps a OpenAI compatible interface on top of Bedrock. So you can leverage the full power of Bedrock without changing your code. This application also has a database, Postgres database, and a Redis cache. Today I'm also really excited to demo a new feature that we've been working on. As we've been onboarding users, one of the questions that we get is, how expensive is this gonna be? I wanna try this out, but I'm not really sure what it's gonna cost me. So we have been exploring ways to estimate your deployment costs before you actually deploy anything. So let's ask, we're gonna use our Defang MCP server today. So let's say, hey, how much would it cost to deploy this to your AWS? Cool, so it's gonna use the Defang MCP server. There's an estimate tool.
We'll run that.
And what it's gonna do is it's gonna look at our compose file, it's gonna translate that into the infrastructure that it would provision, and it's gonna compare that list to a list of known AWS resources and their known cost. So we're only gonna consider like sort of monthly sort of reservation style, baseline cost here. But obviously there could be other charges, associated with like data ingress, egress, et cetera. Those things are a little harder to estimate from this context. So what this is gonna tell us is, this app will, if we deploy this in the affordable deployment mode, so Defang has a couple of different modes that we can deploy with. I'll walk you through some of the other ones. And in this mode, this app would cost $28.7 a month. Okay, so what does that mean? So we've got a load balancer, there's this cost, we've got a Redis cache, that's this cost. We deploy your Redis and your Postgres to the AWS managed database instances. So we'll use RDS, we'll use ElastiCache, et cetera. And then we'll deploy your app to AWS Fargate. So I can say, what are the differences between this and the balanced mode? So at the end there, it said you can also use a balance mode or a high availability mode. So there are different different things that we'll do. You know, we will put your app in multiple availability zones, for example. We'll put your application into, you know, private subnets so that, you know, your database isn't exposed to the internet. You know, different things like that we can do to optimize your deployment. So this is going to run a balanced estimate and then should tell us the difference. So it's more expensive. It's going to upgrade our database size. It's going to put our application behind a NAT gateway and a private network. And those things have some additional costs. So I'm going to say, let's go with the affordable mode. But the database seemed a little small. Let's bump that up to 4 gigabytes and 2 CPUs. So it should edit my Compose file over here. So one thing that a lot of engineers don't realize about Compose is that you actually can describe like the resource requirements of each service in line, which is pretty convenient for our use case. So it's going to run another estimate, and that estimate will include the additional charge of this upgraded database. Cool. So $5 more for that upgraded database. Nice. So I'm going to stop that real quick. I'm going to say, great, let's deploy that. And this thing is going to kick off a deployment for us. Okay, so while it's going, I am going to just show you really quickly what this looks like once you deploy this into your Amazon account. So Defang is not hosting your tool, your application. We're deploying into your cloud account. So you have full control and full visibility over everything that we create. So this application will get deployed to ECS, and you can kind of see, this is a deployment that I did just before it was started, and you can see the different services that we create here, and if I'm on the RDS dashboard, you'll see a database there. So that is my demo. Any questions?
On-prem.
It's definitely like it's in our field of view. Yeah.
Nothing to say about it quite yet, but it's definitely something we're thinking about.
Yeah.
Yes. So your business model is you charge a monthly fee to have access to this?
Yep. Yeah, monthly fee to have access to the tool. Of course, you have free, we're not standing in the way of your resources once we create them.
Right. It's just the convenience.
What if you don't have your cloud set up? You're just building a project outside your desk.
Sorry, outside of your?
It's just building a project off the side of your desk.
Off the side of your desk. So yeah, so if you don't have a cloud account, Defang has a free playground environment. Also, if you want to try out Defang, setting up a cloud account can be a bit of a challenge. So we have a free playground environment that you can deploy to. And we'll host your app for
A long time.
You can try it out.
And
no cloud account required.
Yeah, what's up?
Can you edit existing infrastructure setup that you already have deployed?
So editing it is definitely a little bit more of a challenge. Yeah, if you have something already deployed, you would need to describe it in Compose and then get those things kind of line up. But we can help with that if you want. Give us a shout. Yeah, what's up?
How do you train the Docker container, the LLM?
So we actually don't use any AI in provisioning your cloud infrastructure. It's all rules-based. We think it's really important that it's completely deterministic.
This is, just, I don't even know, quads on it in VS Code, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
Is monitoring also on your roadmap?
Yeah, it is.
it's something that we're thinking about right now. You know, of course, we give you full access to the cloud data monitoring tools. We don't stand in the way of you setting anything up, you know, sort of after you or alongside the deployment, sort of out of scope of your Compose file. But it's something we're thinking about integrating. Sorry?
I hope it goes on call for us too.
Yeah, totally, right? One thing, you know, like sort of big, you know, big picture vision is like, you know, we would like to be able to tightly integrate with metrics as they're happening in your cloud account and then be able to optimize your deployments for you. So right now, like, these resource numbers, like, you're still responsible for these, but it would be great if you weren't. Any other questions?
You showed us affordable amounts.
Yeah.
What's the full?
The other ones, you want to see the cost? Or do you know?
What does it entail?
Oh, so we'll deploy your app into multiple availability zones. That's the biggest difference. Yeah.
What's the difference with this Vercel, like Netify?
Yeah, so this is that you have, the difference with us is that you have complete control over your application and you have the full power of AWS. So you know, usually you deploy with us, can be integrated with the full slew of AWS services. Yeah, what's up?
Follow up, now you have just deployed to the AWS, can I just like click a, maybe a command to stop everything?
Yes, yeah, so we have, so we actually mirror the sort of Docker interface, so like instead of Docker Compose Up, we do Defang Compose Up, and there's a corresponding down, and it'll tear everything back down. Any other questions? Cool, thanks.
Thank you. I thought that was really well attended for you.